But again, we thank you for joining us here for 29th Annual Talladega Ice Bowl. We'll be back again next year, I believe the same weekend on tap in 2021. You can make your plans, come out here and join us. Follow along with Speed Shift TV on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat. Follow along with Talladega Short Track as well. And then obviously Crate Racing USA, big in the Ice Bowl down here. And Adam and our friends, Mitchell out there running around, but follow them as well. Got them doubled up, ready to cut them loose. 8 laps the distance. Again, everybody advances into the feature event tomorrow. Bird down on the inside. The 112 car, the 911 away to the outside, set to bring the field to life. And that is a 112 that looks a lot like a big number one and a little teeny 12. So I shall keep that in mind. Going away. Side by side down the corner. Everybody wants to go to the bottom, and it'll leave the top wide open for somebody from back behind. Might be able to make some hay on him. Meanwhile, up front, it's going to be a 911 to Scooter Ware. Lead the charge down into turn number 3 and 4 and onto the front straightaway. So try to hold it. No. Whoa. Gets swept out wide. Challenge down the inside. Now the 112 car, Tucker Barrett's right there with him. Again, side by side, turn number 1 and 2 will come together just ahead of the number 88 car, Dwayne Vincent. It's Dwayne starting back on the outside of run number 2. Deepman Company down in the corner, top 3 still clustered together. And again, they're racing for position into a feature event tomorrow. So you want to be as close to the front as possible. Still side by side, Tesla play the place up front for that number 1 spot. Just can't shrug off Bird in the 112 car. He's stuck to him like a rat on a Cheeto down in turn number 3 and 4. 911 car Scooter Ware trying to set the pace on him. Got a spinner back in the mid back, and everybody manages to avoid. Caution flag comes out. 2 laps, make that 3 laps scored into books. 5 laps to go. So now Stack is back up. Josh Bondurant, unfortunately, the one that was around down in turn number 3 and 4. If you're into the 10 tops like we have out on the racetrack, as we speak, the Lone Star Stock Car Tour coming up down in Texas. Starts at Abilene Speedway. Actually, it's the 15th through the 22nd, but the 14th will be the prelude to the Lone Star Stock Car Tour. So actually, the 14th through the 22nd, you can join us on SpeedShift TV. Or if you're watching from Texas, we'd love to have you out at one of the racetracks. We kick it off at Abilene. Green flag back out, single file restart, down into the corner they go, and that'll give a little breathing room to Scooter Ware in the 911 car. Should be able to dance his way away from the battle taking place for second. As Dwayne Vincent in number 88 on the attack, trying to get the 112 to Tucker Bird by the wayside. Tucker, too tough to tame though. Maintains about 2 or 3 car length advantage down the front straightaway. Caution flag out for another Tango down at Speedway, a phenomenal racing facility. Located in Illinois, if you get a chance to visit with them or any of their shows, you don't have to pick a special. Just go to Jacksonville. It's a beautiful little bull ring. Starts at 10:45 Central Time is whenever Western Springs fires off to answer your question there, Kenny. So we're back to green down into the corner. 9-11 car going to show the way. Scooter Ware's got a run. He's also got a rear bumper full. And the 112 car, Tucker Bird, a little application of persuasion down into turn number 1 and 2. It didn't take. He'll try to get into turn number 3. Another bumping her up there. So he'll try to clear him out wide. And it looks like the 911 car able to translate that into forward momentum. Dwayne Vincent still running second, the 88 car. And again, all cars do transfer to the big dancer running for position in feature event. Here comes Dwayne down the inside. Got a charge on Bird. Bird out wide. He's going to get caught sleeping. Down into turn number 3, maybe not. Twin sticks come out 2 more times around. It looks like Vincent not able to make the move. The 88 car there, right there by about half car length back in that challenge for second. Meanwhile, back behind, blazing around the top shelf. And the number 33 of Brian Phillips. Phillips has started deep in the field, 7th. He's currently running 4th, and he is in no man's land on the top side of the racetrack. The white flag coming out, and he's got a run to the outside. Here he comes. Brian Phillips under full sail down into turn number 1 and 2 and around the outside of the number 78 car. And David Stern will push him back a spot. He's going to get a run on P3 before it's all said and done. He is hot to trot on the top shelf. Just lays that baby into the cushion onto the front straightaway. Can't get a run on the 88 car, but what a drive for the number 33 of Brian Phillips. Meanwhile, up front, Scooter Ware picking up the win in 9-11 car. And that'll do it for heat race number 2 and take us into the deuce. Heat race number 2 of 3 for the factory stocks. Get them gridded up. If you want to see the lineups for yourself, you can find them on the My Race Pass app. download, load that onto your phone or your desktop or wherever it may be and find lineups and much, much more. Timing and scoring not working for us tonight for anybody. As a matter of fact, other than timing scoring on their laptop, they have a software or hardware issue they're trying to fight out. So our apologies for that. Green flag comes out. Good start down on the inside for 21 C-car Chapman. My goodness gracious. Shot out of turn number four and into the race lead. He's got a little company coming to the outside to slip the grip for Josh Holbrook, the number 18 car, giving up a spot. The M1 of Austin McCarn. McCarn will move into third on the field. The battle's up front. So on the front straightaway comes the 21C car. Chapman still hanging on, at least for now. For a little bit longer, perhaps. 23 car Chase Aldridge to the outside, and Aldridge goes up into the roses. Now to turn number two and down the back straightaway by two car lengths. The advantage for the 21C of Chapman up front. Meanwhile, back in P3 on the field, Holbrook now taking a look down to the inside of the M1 car. McCarn just slippery enough to hang on to third for now. Third, fourth, and fifth in a little bit of a clump. Meanwhile, up front, stretching his legs on him, goes Chapman in the 21C. He'll bring it around for lap number three, and he is working the top side of the racetrack. Everybody going to the cushion. In two heat races, we went from the bottom to the top, and it seems like that is the quick way around. Got the dust blowed off of it. He'll blow a little bit more in the face of the fan sitting down out of turn number two as he heads down the back straightaway for Chapman. As he has got a merry voyage going on. Bring it around halfway through. Cross flags come out. Four in the books. Four to go for the 21C car up front. As everyone's kind of found their way. So we get way back in field, back in the battle for sixth. As the 24 car trying to fend him off. Sky Aldridge. Up sideways. Just as I talked about him, I laid the heebie-jeebie on him. And he pivots around. He's going to bring out the caution flag for us here on lap number four. Out, lights down around the racetrack. Going green coming out of the corner. Still four remain. Chapman looks to have the field covered up front as he snakes his way into turn number three. Keeping them on their toes. Brings her down off the banking. Right to the top side of the racetrack. That is a tricky trail to tread. It's going to bite him there for Austin. McCarn gets through in the M1 car to the inside of Aldridge. As Aldridge just a tick too high. Back end got loose on him. He opened up the door and rolled out the red carpet. And the M1 car quick to capitalize. McCarn back through the field. I thought the 33 car is going to be able to make something happen. We're still green flag racing. And again, your top five all working the top side of the racetrack. The 9 car, Chris Knight, might be able to make a move on the number 18 of Josh Holbrook here for the battle for fourth before it's all said and done. Here comes Knight down off the banking. Nope, not going to find the velocity he needs, at least that time around. So white flag's going to flutter about for Chapman next time out of turn number four, and he's got himself about a half a straightaway advantage over the M1 of Austin McCarn, who snaked away that second spot from the 23 of Chase Aldridge on the restart. As the song has been sung, although I continue to watch Knight in the 9 car. I just feel like he's got a little something extra in the tank. We're going to find out. He's working just two car widths lower. He's got a run to the inside. The number 18 of Holbrook. Look, got almost clipped the rear quarter. So get out of the throttle and drop back in line. Here's checkered flag coming out up front for Chapman. He's got this one into the books. Knight's not going to get there in time. So Chapman picking up the win. The M1 of Austin McCarn finishes out second, rounding out the top three with 23 of Chase Aldridge. We go into our final heat race for the factory stocks. Scotty Dial to his outside, the S4 car. Got quite a bit of attitude to that race car. That thing's got the old potato digger set up on it. It's like my dad's old 74 Ford truck. Must have heavy-duty springs in the back. So Horton set to bring the field to life. L1 car down the inside, Dial to the outside. As they'll tighten up on him, green flag. This time out of turn number four, 8 laps of distance. Good start. Better start for some than others. Two of Mark Price got down the inside. A little Weber wobble and gives up the positions. They roll out. Oh, my. We got a run coming from row number two. Keep your eye on Aldridge down the back straightaway. 24 car currently scored third on the field. Looked like he had pretty good speed down turn number one and two. Caution flag comes out, and we got one stopped at the top of the racetrack down in turn number one. Such an awesome facility over there. So the 9 car, Brad Baker trying to get his position back down to the inside. Looks like they let him do so because we didn't score a lap into the books. Fall back through. Better challenge up front that time to get one car. Lucas Horton not going to be able to hold off Scotty Dial. Dial got her digging harder down the back chute into turn number three. Here comes the 24 car again, Aldridge. Well, I thought whenever we initially kicked this baby loose, might have the fastest car on the racetrack. We're going to find out. Numbers are hard to read on the back sheet. You can see them fine on the front straightaway, though, for the number 24 car. As Levi pedals it right around the cushion. Two car, Mark Price running fourth on the field. Follows long and hot pursuit. Meanwhile, your race leader up front across for lap number two. That time by for Lucas Horton. Rather running into second spot. Scotty Dow, the S4 car, currently your race leader. Started on the outside of row number one. Capitalized on that position. So far has led all three laps that we've scored into the books. He's watching back through the field. Looks like we got a little bit of freight train formation. Everybody's kind of found their way. It was headed towards these final five, soon to be four laps as the cross flags come out. Looks like the 01 car, Lucas Horton, not going to be able to get up there and challenge, at least with the line he's running. He's got her way down low, and boy, that thing kind of slams on the binder. She hunkers into the dirt and got a good pivot, just can't maintain the speed to hang with the S4 car, Scotty Dow up front. 24 car so far has not arrived on scene. He continues to go to the dust off, though, Levi Aldridge. Giving it to Wet Force now, dropped down about a car width off the top shelf. An attempt to shorten up the racetrack, but maintain the momentum. Two car watching on from fourth, Mark Price. Four cars are broken away from the other four cars as twin sticks come out. Two laps to go. And we got one around on turn number three and four. Just as I looked at him, all it took was a glance. Just pow. Jenkstein brings out the caution flag, stacks up the field. Green's out, there's the attack coming out of the 24, Aldridge. Boy, he timed that one right. He was almost able to get down to the inside of Horton. Horton able to hold him at bay, at least for a little while, but Aldridge right there pestering out of turn number two. Got a little loose. Back in, stepped out from underneath. He spun the tires on it, and he'll give up car length. Red flag coming out up front for your race leader. Scotty Dow around for one more time. Uncontested. So that number one spot ain't going to happen that time. Al, the 01 to Lucas Horton either. He continues to persist down the inside of the racetrack. Levi Aldridge, third on the field. I believe the song has been sung. Checkered flag comes out. We'll put that one into the books. 1-2-3 on the field. Just like I said, the number two car, Mark Price, fourth. Rounding out your top five. It's going to be the R25 with Dusty Richardson. That'll do it for our factory stocks. Takes into a little hot shot action. So bring him out, and here's your running order for the B-Main event. Josh Bondurant, out of Lynchburg, Tennessee, 07 car on the inside of row number one. The outside, Lane Wakefield, out of Linville, Alabama, the 32 JR. Austin Matsky, out of Shelby, Alabama, the 56, rolls off inside row number two. The outside from Pell City, Alabama, the number 14, Jason Ledlow. Casey Allred, out of Jasper, Alabama, the 9A car to the inside of row number four. To the outside, Brock Tolbert, out of Jasper, Alabama, the W5. Takes us back to row number four, inside. We will find Talladega, Alabama's Jeremy Key in the number 39, and his outside, the 24 S car hailing from Madison, Alabama, Sky Aldridge. Mike Garris out of Clanton, Alabama, the X car to the inside. Row number five, Jeff Beecham to the outside in the 77B, and rounding out the field is the Eddie Riddle, Folkville, Alabama racer in the number 28. Top eight to advance. So pulling the top eight out of this B-Main event, it looks like so only three cars won't make the call into the feature events. Just one B-Main for the factory stocks. Green flag flutters about. We're off and running. She is tight down into turn number one and two. A little bit of contact taking place there in the mid-pack. Able to force her way out of it and charge down the back straightaway. So only two cars not making it out. One car not able to make the calls. We got a spinner, and there's an elimination down on the inside. Turn number three and four, another spinner coming out of the corner, trying to keep it rolling as the caution flag comes out. Five car might be able to get the spot back. Allred, though, the 9A car is the one that caught the tire down on the inside. Could be some front end damage to his hot rod. We'll find out if he's able to tag back into the field. And I don't know if he scored that first lap or not, although it is showing up on the scoreboard. Josh Bondurant, 07 car up front on the point. The 56, Austin Matsky running second on the field. Behind him, the number 32 JR, Lane Wakefield, Jeremy Key. Mike Garrison, the X-Car, the 14 of Jason Ledlow. Sky Aldridge, the 24S and 77B of Jeff Beecham, the ones that are currently in a transfer. See if it stays that way. Green flag comes out, and away we go. A little skip to the loop. Here comes the X-Car down the inside. Mike Garrison's the one who's trying to make moves on the initial start of this race. He tries it again down turn number one and two and draws alongside the 39 of Jeremy Key. No drag racer layout. Turn number two and down the back straightaway. He's going to have to run her deep down in the corner. Key goes right to the cushion up high. Brought it down off. We got a couple of spinners at the back of the field. Two cars around. One car kind of bobbing and weaving through, and that's the number nine car of Aldred. And he catches a little bit of a break and inherits a transfer spot. As now we got the tail feathers ripped off the number five car. Tuck them up, tighten them up. Two laps scored into books. Eight laps to go. The only B-Main event for the factory stocks and the final B-Main of the day. Green flag comes out quickly. We're back underway. Watching the X-Car, Mike Garris looks to be the man on the move. Now goes top shelf, turn number one and two, trying to get a run. On a little side-by-side action taking place just ahead of number 24 cars right there, the 39 as well. Sky Aldridge was able to pick up a spot, move into fifth on the field, and get himself a little further up through. Working wheel coming out of the corner and down the front straightaway. Into fourth, but man, that thing is wandering around like a lost child, somehow fighting the wheel of the 24S car for Aldridge. Moved into fourth. Again, we're taking the top eight. That transfer spot, tail of the field in danger. Here comes the green high rod out of the corner. The number 14 car's got it. Jason Ledlow, who had fallen back into eighth on the field, is now trying to hang on to a transfer spot. Just behind him, Jeff Beecham in the 77B and the W5 of Brock Tolbert. Both out looking in, and oh, hot for that transfer spot. I thought he was going to take him around there. Got on the binders hard, didn't even make contact for the number 14 car. Man had a good run through the apex. That time pushes up high. Here comes the number W5 down to the inside. Meanwhile, mid-pack, we got a move for motion. Now the number nine. Allred, who had gone to the tail of the field, trying to weasel his way back up through and get a better starting spot in tonight's feature event. Still side-by-side up ahead, as well as the 24 car now goes into third. Aldridge has got a good run going on. It started back on the outside of row number four in the number eight starting spots. Currently raced up into third for Aldridge in the 24s. The white flag comes out. We'll take him around one more time. Final transfer spot still in the hands of the number 14 car to keep you abreast of that situation. It's down the back chute. We go up front. It's been Bondurant the whole time. So he'll take her through the corner. Tiptoe out and onto the front straightaway. Pick up the checkered flag and head back into the pits and get ready for the feature event a little bit later on. 56 car of Matsky will finish out second. Aldridge all the way from 8th to 3rd to number 24. Wakefield will finish out 4th in the 32 JR. Mike Garris, Casey Allred, Jeremy Key, and Jeff Beecham in the 77B car will be your final transfer as Ledlow, unfortunately, as we turned our attention away, fell out of contention. Stone has to pull the infield, so it's over for him before he even began. He waited all this time, and now he's not able to join in the feature event, and that's got to be frustration of a huge magnitude. So lights down around the racetrack. We will lose Stern, unfortunately. 78 car bows out. Green flag is set to fly up front. Scooter Ware down on the inside. The 911 car, Russell Chapman, the 21C car to the outside. We are underway here with the factory stocks, and holy hot mama, 21C car came out of turn number four like his butt was on fire and down the front straightaway and pulled about four or five car lengths on the rest of the field. That thing is ready to rear and go. So he'll take it right through the slick stuff down turn number three and four and onto the front straightaway. Just left everybody behind in a swirling vortex of dust. Holbrook, the number 18 car, settles into the number two spot. Behind him, Chris Knight, the number nine car, rounds out those top three, I believe, is how they are currently scored out. We'll find out whenever they come around this time. We've got to take a look at the side of the race cars. Yep, that is number nine. Boy, that looks like a number one from far away, though. I'm not going to lie to you. Back behind him comes Sal Smith, the number 13, Jordan Phillips. Maybe? Maybe not. It doesn't seem right to me. I feel like we got the wrong timing and scoring up here. I can't go off of that. Let's take a look at it, though. It is a 21C car up front. Chapman showing away. Rocket Bird, 112 car. I believe is the one scored second on the field. We'll get herself straightened out here just a little. S4, Scotty Dow running third. Now I got to figure it out. We'll go back and do it old school, looking around. We got three wide back in the field. Coming out, turn number two and down the back shoot. Top three is separated out over the fourth running. Austin McLaren, the M1 car, currently scored fourth on the field, back behind. Make sure that's right. Yep. Down into the quarter, caution flag coming out. Now give me time to kind of learn the cars just a little bit better. I was relying too much on timing and scoring. I thought it was going too well for him up there. I'm not going to lie to you. So we got our spinner down in turn number four. That'll stack the field back up for us. So single foul restart coming at you here with the factory stocks. Five laps scored into books, 20 laps to go. Everybody hot on the heels up front of Russell Chapman in the 21C car. We'll see what he's got for us this run down into turn number one and two. A slow one down the back straight. We're going to stay green anyhow. I think we're just going to pull it to the infield. So far, so good. Chapman didn't pull away from the field like we saw during the initial start of this one. Side by side, back behind. We're going to go three wide. Big run wide out of turn number four, coming out of the number 23 car. Trying to make some hay up through there. Chase Aldridge scored fifth on the field. One of the lone warriors out. Tiptoeing where none dare tread in the number 23 car. He'll run her deep down to the inside, or the outside rather, to Austin McCarn. The M1 car is a caution flag. Comes out for the number 24 round down in turn number one. Sky Aldridge backed in with the trunk flap up. So Chapman up front. Didn't leap away from him like he did on the initial start of the race. He's going to get a little bumping her up down the back straightaway, just the presence being known there from Tucker Bird in the 112 car. Bird trying to get a run on him. Had good timing out of the 112 car. Tried to challenge, came up and rubbed him. Then falls by the wayside and under the attack of Scotty Dow in the S4 car. That's not the S4, that's the L1 car. That's Horton. Horton now goes to the outside. The L1 car pedaling for all he's worth. Then caution flag coming out for two of them around. We got a slow one on the front straightaway. Two of them around in turn number two, and we're going to caution to back up again. Racetrack now, we're going to tuck them up. Single foul restart coming at you. We'll watch the 21C car, Russell Chapman up front. Last time, 112 of Tucker Bird was right there. The L1 car of Horton. It's Horton, good run looking to the outside. Bird just a tick quicker, pulls half a car line coming out of the corner, side by side, back behind. We got one around on the front straightaway. Caution coming out as he is in harm's way out on the front chute, so we will not score that lap into the books. Motion for the quad to, there it goes. Tucker Bird. Lucas Horton, second and third so far. Those positions remained unchanged. Here comes the green flag, and away we go. We're giving a little nudge out of the corner. She got a little tight. Rolling down the front straightaway. 78 car down on the inside. That's our slow roller. As here comes Horton on the attack, looking for second, deep down into turn number three. Draws alongside contact. The 112 car goes around, stacks up the field down the corner, full wide under caution onto the front straightaway. And another daisy chain of chaos. Still 13 laps remaining for this feature events. Chapman this time able to get a little breathing room on the start. Didn't take the shot that he took out of the 112 car, Tucker Bird, like the last time. Bird able to close down the front straightaway into the corner, however. Back behind, we got him side by side through turn number two and onto the back straightaway. The number 13 car trying to make something happen. Keep her down on the inside of the racetrack. Still side by side onto the front chute. Good move. 13 car powers on through. Picks up a spot for Smith. Clinton, Alabama runner. Might be one of the few on the move, although I say that just ahead, we're going to have a challenge for position down into turn number three. That battle taking place for sixth on the field. And a good strong run out of the front straightaway for the number 33 car, able to power out. Pick up a spot for Phillips, who had started back on the inside of row number nine. having a rough time. He's locked in that little bit of a battle right there with Scooter Ware in the 911 car as the caution flag comes out for the X car around down on the inside. Garris brings out his second caution of the feature events. We did score two laps into the book, so nine laps up on the scoreboard and 11 laps remain. Back to green down in turn number four. Turn number one and two we go. Sorry, caught me there. I was visiting. Wasn't ready for that. Song remains the same up front though. Russell Chapman in the 21C car. Hanging on to the race lead down in turn number one and two. He's got himself a nice little advantage over the 112 car. Tucker Bird running second on the field. We've separated ourselves out and given a little breathing room all the way back through. Somebody trying to settle down. We're starting to settle down, I should say. Quick little jump around, lap number 11 scored in the books that time by the starter stands. Looking at the battle taking place a little further back and forth, right around the number 9 car, Chris Knight. Knight gave up a spot to Jordan Phillips in the 33P car. As Phillips down the inside tries to challenge for another spot as he goes to work on the number 18 of Josh Holbrook. Holbrook just a tick out wider, and here comes a little company right behind the 33P as well. Levi Aldridge is there in the number 24 car. Everybody trying to be good boys and girls down into turn number three and four and onto the front straightaway. That's a great battle taking place and a good way to weasel up through the field for the number 33 of Jordan Phillips. Phillips able to clear Holbrook, push him back into ninth as they rifle down the back straightaway into turn number three and four yet again. Meanwhile, up front, nobody able to get up and challenge Russell Chapman. As the battle takes place back in the mid-pack. Tucker Bird all by his lonesome running second on the field. They've actually pulled some distance on the S4 car. There's Scotty Dial, who scored third. Austin McCarney, the M1 car, runs fourth. Fifth is the number 23 of Chase Aldridge. Then a little bit of a gap back to the number 33 Brian Phillips. Phillips hot on his heels. Kyle Smith in the number 13 runs seventh. Eighth is Jordan Phillips in the 33P. Levi Aldridge and Josh Holbrook as the caution flag comes out for spinner and debris down in turn number two. Chapman just needs to hold him off for a few more in the 21C car. Pick up the victory here at the Talladega Ice Bowl. So watching way up high on the banking. Bird trying to hang tough with him. Here comes a big run down off for the S4 car, Scotty Dow. Might be a little closer when he got down in turn number one and two. That's not the case. Around the outside goes the number 13 car, Kyle Smith. Smith going where the eight powers to the outside of Brian Phillips, the number 33 car, down in turn number three and four. And Smith brings her onto the front straightaway. A lot of speed, a lot of velocity. He's got him picked off down into the corner. Now goes to work on the car up in front. Might be able to make a move around Chase Aldridge, the number 23 car next time by. Just needs to be careful. Oh, comes up a little shot in the shorts down into the corner. And that's usually what kicks loose a caution flag for us, and that's not the case that time. Phew, we narrowly escaped. He's down into the corner to go. The 01 car coming from the tail of the field. Remember him? Yeah, he was way up there. Horton trying to get on through. His caution flag comes out, slowing down the back straightaway as we got just three laps remaining, two laps scoring into books. Should be able to hear this weekend. So apparently a green-white checker coming at him. So they are told a green-white checker finish on this. We're underway. Watching the 13 car, Kyle Smith back behind now, got her down on the inside, trying to make a move on the number 23 of Chase Aldridge and pick up a spot before it's all said and done. He's got to give it to what for? Down into turn number three and four. Aldridge quick enough to hold him off. White flag comes out up front for Chapman. Russell Chapman, who had started on the outside of row number one, took over the race lead so far, has maintained a nice little advantage over the rest of the field. That's how he's going to finish it off as well. Deep down into turn number three and onto the front straightaway. Checkered flag comes out. And the factory stock feature event's going to go to Russell Chapman. Second goes to Tucker Bird in the 112 car, and nice Scotty Dow, I believe, finishes out third in the S4. We got a spinner down turn number two, but it matters not. That one is complete. Hot Shots coming up next.
Russell Chapman making his way.
All righty is what I was getting ready to say. Crowd getting a little rowdy out there. I'm not exactly sure what's taking place.
As Russell Chapman makes his way to the Talladega short track victory lane.
Just wanted to make sure. I thought maybe he got a DQ down there in the scale house and tech area, but that's not the case. Chapman is just coming out and getting pivoted around to get his photo taken to victory lane. No victory lap for him, which means the four cylinders of Fury are rolling out onto the racing surface. Line up.